No matter what ELO you find yourself in, the concept of being stuck in a specific rank is engraved into the mind of most, if not all, competitive players. Although a consistent loop of winning and losing is sure to cause frustration, the common resort of blaming teammates or diminishing your mistakes on having an off day is not going to get you very far. Because of this, we are here to provide you with personalized tips and tricks that will help you escape each individual rank and reach your desired goals. Hello, ProGuides family. My name is Renox, and today we'll be going over how you can escape your ELO and climb to whatever rank you desire. If you hop online and consistently think to yourself why you can't push out of iron or why you found yourself unable to finally tilt past diamond and make your way onto that sought-after immortal rank, this video is for you. Now, without any further ado, let's get into what you should be personally focusing on in order to climb the ladder. If you feel like you have not been playing a lot yet and can't get out of iron, there is no need to worry. This is the perfect time to truly get a grip of the fundamentals that are required, not only to reach bronze, but also ranks much higher like gold or plat. I don't doubt that you must have heard the concept of learning fundamentals in the past, but you might have found yourself wondering what that actually means in the case of Valorant. Well, firstly, you should focus on your fundamentals of the game itself. For instance, taking some time to truly understand when it is ideal to tap, burst, or spray your respective gun at the time is going to significantly increase your chances to win duels at any range. Another factor that is also associated with game fundamentals is map callouts. This may not be directly help you at winning duels or doing particularly better yourself, it will no doubt help you better understand the game and allow you to make callouts from your team, and which in turn will help you win more games. Secondly, after you learn the general fundamentals of this game, it is ideal to focus all of your time into two or three agents in order to learn the ins and outs of your agent pool. This will allow you to truly perform your best in every scenario with the abilities that you have, no matter what agents you choose to play. The alternative to this situation would be spreading your time amongst all the available agents, which would unquestionably reduce the rate at which you improve and are able to rank up. This is because it would take significantly more time to learn the in-depth tactics and how to react to enemy executes when trying to learn every agent rather than what you simply focus on improving with a limited roster. Firstly, I would like to say that if you have made your way to bronze, great job! You undoubtedly understand the general fundamentals of the game and have gained the necessary skills required to climb out of iron. Now, before reaching higher ranks where lacking this skill will significantly reduce your win potential, you need to gain the knowledge required to truly understand the minimap and use the crucial information that it provides to your advantage. It is likely that if you were not fortunate enough to place into bronze, you would have likely have found the minimap to be overwhelming when having to climb out of iron. Once you have done so, however, learning the minimap will truly give you an edge over your enemies and other people in your rank. Although your teammates should always call out enemy locations when gaining sight of them, you have probably realized by now that this doesn't always happen. Sometimes you will just have to rely on your own awareness and utilization of the information provided to you in order to know when to rotate or when to communicate to your team that you're in danger. Furthermore, the minimap will also allow you to understand plays that your team is attempting to execute. For example, if you see a teammate attempting to flank the enemy, it is probably not a good idea to hold back very far. You might want to sandwich the enemy in order to trade for your teammates or to even kill more enemies. In addition to learning the minimap, bronze is also the time to begin pointing out your mistakes. At this point, you should already have enough knowledge to understand what you are doing wrong rather than tilting after every death. Asking yourself what you could have done better might help you in similar situations later on. Furthermore, you can also utilize the power of self-evaluation when something does go your way. For instance, if you push up and get a kill or two, ask yourself why that worked. Doing this might allow you to differentiate that play from the one that you did two or three games ago that didn't end as well. Ultimately, no matter if your in-game risk pays off or you get killed, understanding why the outcome was what it was will undoubtedly assist you in the future. Once you have finally reached silver, you should already know what to do in most situations, even if you have not yet mastered how to perfectly execute the tactics that you were thinking up mid-game. In order to better yourself at this point, one major step you could take towards the higher ranks is gaining knowledge regarding common map spots on every map. This will directly help you win more duels when attacking and retaking sites on defense. Think about it this way. Let's say you are attacking from short on the map bind. If you were going in blind, you would most likely swing wide in an attempt to clear the sight, which would likely get you shot from almost every direction. Alternatively, if you knew where the defenders were likely to hold, you could clear those spots much easier. In this case, you would likely clear lamps, heaven, and default one by one in order to ensure that you will not be shot from more than one location at a time. Ultimately, this will result in you winning more duels and becoming a more valuable teammate to your team. In addition to advancing your knowledge of the map, you can also significantly benefit from truly understanding the value of the economy throughout the game. This includes what to buy and when to buy it, alongside knowing when to save and when it might be better to go for exits, even if it puts you at a risk of dying. I know that might sound like a lot, but let's start from the top, knowing when to buy. At first, this seems simple. Buy when you have money, don't when you don't. Easy, right? Well, this is not always the case. For instance, if you lost the first round yet you killed four of the enemies in addition to planting the bomb, your team would likely have enough money to buy weapons that would give them a good chance of winning the second round. Ideally, this would also make the enemies broke for round three, which would put you in the lead going into round four. While you may want to buy sometimes, however, breaking the bank is not ideal all of the time, as it can put you into a loop of losing rounds and forcing guns, which will cause you to go down many rounds very quickly. Situations like these are why the economy is so important. Secondly, you want to focus on when it is good to go for a save and when it is better to go for exits. This decision is only to be made when you have one or maybe two people alive and the bomb has already been planted. Positively, however, this decision is usually easy to make. If your team is sitting better financially than the enemy, it is worth it to risk dying in an attempt to take valuable guns away from the enemies. On the other end, if you are very low in money, it is usually better to save and buy a gun for an ally in order to have a better chance at winning the next round. Gold is an interesting rank. If you have reached this far, congratulations! You have surpassed the lower leagues and are now well on your way to becoming a more advanced player. However, beware, gold is where many people begin to face the massive roadblocks due to the simple fact that this is the ELO where many players make the decision to take the game more seriously. In an attempt to help you avoid spending weeks or even months in gold, let's go over some slightly more advanced tactics that could help you rank up faster. Firstly, rotating. Before gold, rotating likely seemed very simple. If you're defending on B and your team calls A, rotate. No longer should this be your thought process, however. Gold players are likely to think more about their playstyles and strategies to get onto site. You will see a lot more fakes and rotations from the attackers. When defending, try to remember these rules regarding rotation. If you are holding a site and a teammate calls one or two people in another area, don't instantly rotate. Wait for one of three situations to play out. One, if your team calls out a bomb, this can be your cue to assist them simply because any flankers coming to your site will have no power without the spike. Two, if your teammates begin to die, this can also be a good reason to rotate. You don't want the enemy to plant the spike while you're still across the map holding a different site. Three, ideally, if your teammates are able to hold their ground and kill a few enemies without dying, don't worry about rotating over. In this case, many teams will decide to save or come to another site. If they choose the latter, you will be there to stop their push and deny them the spike plant. Other than rotating, gold is also the rank in which developing movement abilities like jiggle peeking is crucial. This isn't really a difficult concept to comprehend, but it is an important one. Jiggle peeking will allow you to gain information regarding the enemy without having to use any of your abilities. I will not go in depth on how to jiggle peek since we have another video in the works dedicated to this topic. However, you should know that gold is where you should start focusing on mastering small movement tactics such as these. Plat is the gateway rank into the higher leagues. If you find yourself in plat and can't seem to climb to diamond, you are sure to experience a bit of frustration at some point or another. Talking about frustration, however, let's discuss why tilting truly starts to take its toll at this rank. Previous to plat, many players are often not able to punish those who push in or force buy every round due to tilting from previous rounds or games. However, once you have surpassed the threshold of casual to advanced, people will begin to exploit your misplays much more. From personal experience, I can say that I have seen many good players, maybe even diamond level, stuck in low to mid plat due to tilt. They find themselves winning a decent amount, however, when a loss or two hit, they continue playing and experience significant drops in ELO over a short period of time. Although it may seem bland, as you've probably heard the phrase, "don't play when you're tilted," hundreds of times, it truly does help to take a small break. Now, this doesn't mean that if you have an off game, you shouldn't play for the rest of the week, but if you feel like you are consistently doing bad at something, just do something else for an hour or two to take your mind off the game. Take a shower, eat a snack, go for a walk, play with your dog, anything that helps. After that, even if your break was only 15 minutes, come back and give it another try. You will feel significant improvements in mentality and aim when you are refreshed. Secondly, perhaps a more direct approach to improving is truly mastering your abilities. By this rank, you have likely already chosen your desired playstyle and characters that cater to it. So, as you may have imagined, mastering your abilities really is the next step. For instance, if you play Phoenix, you surely know that you can use his Blaze ability, or Wall as many people call it, in order to heal yourself. However, once you become a more skillful player, understanding that you can also use walls to split sights on attack is crucial information that may help you win important rounds throughout the game. If you have hit Diamond and are looking to hit Immortal, you undoubtedly know that you have already surpassed 90% of the general population. Nice job, because you have likely already grasped the knowledge required to play your individual character pool at a very high level. Now is the time to begin focusing on teamwork. Although this seems like a low-level concept, simply because people in ranks such as Gold and Silver already understand what that is, better to push in rather than play alone, this is not what I'm talking about. When I say synergy, I am mostly talking about team compositions and ability coordination. For instance, although a Sage may often use her wall to take sights such as B on split, she may find it more beneficial to throw a slow orb rather than using her wall during a specific fight only because Phoenix stated that he was going to use his ultimate. Understanding that the use of walls would restrict Phoenix from gaining sightlines on the enemy is what truly distinguishes Diamond players from Immortal players. Plays like these, although situational, are crucial when trying to reach ranks composed of the top 1% of players in your respective region. Secondly, another aspect that plays a big part in synergy is team composition. Many games in higher ranks are lost on the agent select screen, simply because one team chooses an ideal meta comp while the other team is missing smokes and has too many duelists. Because of this, Diamond is where you may want to slightly expand your agent pool. This doesn't mean that you need to learn to play every agent in the roster, however. Learning an extra few, perhaps a duelist and an agent that has a smoke at his disposal, may help you win a few more games and reduce the tilt from your teammates. To all of the people out there who find themselves not able to surpass a certain rank, we hope this video helped. This is all we have for you today, but focusing on the tips we gave will surely help you rank up on the ladder and become a more skillful player. In addition, before ending this video off, I would like to say that the tips provided are not solely for the ranks we place them at. For instance, if you are a Gold player, yet you feel you are still struggling with a concept discussed in the Silver section, feel free to practice that as well. All of the tactics build off of each other and ultimately are intended to help you improve. Anyways, good luck, stay safe, and I wish you all great games.